we do have some things to talk about in this week's hobby happening segment as well. So without further ado, let's cover some things going on, news, notes, and nuggets wise in this hobby that we know and love. So a quick reminder, as I mentioned earlier, this Saturday, August 5th, is Topps International Trading Card Day. Collectors can grab a free pack at any participating LCS. Plus, be sure to pick up a bonus card with any $10 purchase. You can visit tops.com to find the store locator.
Panini kicked off its Arch Manning NIL partnership with his first trading card being auctioned, with all proceeds benefiting the St. David's Healthcare and St. David's Foundation, a Central Texas nonprofit. Arch's first NIL trading card is a one-of-one throwback prism with an on-card autograph. The bidding jumped from $70,000 to six figures in the final hours before closing at $102,500. The anonymous winning bidder will have a special meet and greet with Arch that will include throwing the football around, as well as participating in presenting the money to the nonprofit. Manning will be included in Panini's collegiate and NIL trading card products. He and Panini will also collaborate to develop special Arch Manning NIL cards each season throughout the agreement. Panini will also feature Manning in select marketing projects. That sounds really promising.
Congrats, Panini. Well, Fanatic CEO Michael Rubin walked the show floor at the National Sports Collectors Convention, checking out cards, engaging with collectors, and sharing his vision for the future of the industry. In an exclusive impromptu interview with Sports Collectors Digest, Michael Rubin and Fanatics Collectibles CEO Mike Mahan fielded questions about the National and Fanatics vision for the future of the sports card hobby. Quote, it's incredible to see so much passion and enthusiasm, Rubin said about Thursday's crowd at the National. He went on to say, you come in here and there's so many incredible collectors who just leave, breathe, eat the hobby. And how's that not make you so happy and excited? By the way, we were just talking about it a minute ago. You just think about all the things we're doing. We're just getting started with all the plans that we have, and there's an incredible foundation and so much to do. Mahan added, I think when you see this kind of passion, this kind of turnout, it gives you a lot of confidence for where you're going. The number of people that have come up to each one of us excited about the things we're doing and us knowing that we're just getting started, that this is just the beginning, is really exciting. Be sure to check out the complete article on Sports Collectors Digest.
So when Joe Burrow went down with a calf injury last week, it wasn't the only moment that would have made his collectors' hearts sink. Alton Insights reported that last Wednesday, Golden sold one of Burrow's coveted rookie cards, the National Treasure 1-of-1 Laundry Tag RPA, for $84,000. Well, a year ago, that very same card sold at PWCC for a whopping $204,000. Well, you know, that's a decrease of 59% in value.
That's sad.
Yeah, well, when you play the stock market, Rob, these days, it goes up, it goes down. 401ks go up and down, IRA, all that stuff. So,
well, grab your popcorn. The legal battle between Panini and Fanatics has escalated quickly. Today, Panini America filed a federal antitrust suit against Fanatics, alleging that its new rival has attempted to monopolize the market for trading cards with its dramatic foray into the sector 2 years ago. In the lawsuit filed in U.S. District Court in Florida, Panini alleges that Fanatics violated federal antitrust law with its aggressive move into the trading card business in August of 2021. The complaint also accuses Fanatics of violating various state laws by interfering with Panini's business through actions such as allegedly disparaging the company to industry partners. Panini is seeking unspecified damages. based on the quotes in this Wall Street article, though, this is going to be an ugly, nasty, and lengthy drama. David Boies, chairman of Boies, Schiller, and Flexner, the firm representing Panini, said, "What Fanatics has done is essentially lock out competition, literally for decades, in all three major sports trading card markets. That obviously hurts consumers, and Fanatics' behavior is the behavior of a typical monopolist." Boies went on to say, "By combining long-term exclusive licenses for every major U.S. professional sports league, Fanatics positions itself to drive Panini and other potential competitors out of the market and erected barriers to entry, blocking their return. A monopolistic outcome here will harm the public, consumers, and competition by allowing Fanatics complete control to set and raise prices for MLB, NBA, and NFL trading card sets." Closed quote. Well, responding, a Fanatics spokesperson called the lawsuit, quote, "a baseless last gasp, flailing effort by a company that has lost touch with its consumers, is failing in the marketplace, and has tried unsuccessfully for years to sell itself. At Fanatics, we remain focused on innovation and working to improve an industry that has been sleepily led by Panini for years." Panini's lawsuit alleges that Rubin bragged to people in the industry that it would also force Panini to sell itself to Fanatics. The lawsuit says that Fanatics took various steps to exert a pressure campaign against Panini, and that in May of this year, Rubin approached Panini and conveyed that it wouldn't stop. The lawsuit also says that through superior innovation and competitive success, Panini achieved great results for the leagues and reliably increased revenue. According to figures from Panini, its trading card business has grown from $200 million in 2017 to over $1 billion in 2022. Mm-hmm. The lawsuit also accuses Fanatics of attempting to undermine Panini's current business even before before its current licenses run out. It says Fanatics acquired a controlling stake in the trading card manufacturer Graphic Converting Printing that produces over 90% of Panini's trading cards, and that GCP is the only U.S. manufacturer that meets Panini's technological quality and capacity requirements. And it says Fanatics has used its control of GCP to restrict Panini's supply of trading cards despite their contracted agreements. This is just ugly. The federal antitrust lawsuit also says that Fanatics disseminated false derogatory statements about Panini to entice employees to leave the company and join Fanatics, and that the company succeeded in luring away 36 employees by leveraging these false and disparaging statements. The lawsuit adds that Fanatics made similar such statements to players and agents to get them to refrain from doing business with Panini. A Fanatics spokesperson responded saying, "Panini is trying to blame Fanatics for its own inability to keep pace with what players, fans, and even its own employees rightly want." Like I said, folks, this is going to get ugly, and it's just the beginning. I am sure Paul Lesko, Hobby Legal Eagle at Paul_Lesko, will have lots of thoughts and feedback and following on this as this progresses, but this is pretty much in a nutshell on what we know right now.
Like you said, Rob, get your popcorn ready, because it's going to be an ugly, ugly fight. It really will be. Yeah. For a limited time, ComC is running a special with 30% off all submissions, including the classic standard service level, meaning processing is only 35 cents per card. Don't miss out on this amazing discount available for the first time ever. Also, Beckett announced that their new Las Vegas office is now open for appointments. Beckett authentication submissions are processed on site, allowing collectors to conveniently pick up orders once it's complete. Occasionally, same-day service may be offered. Also, BGS, CBCS, tickets, and VHS submissions will be collected and shipped weekly to the company's Dallas office for processing.
And that's a look at this week's Hobby Happenings.